and gentlemen, I'm Siege.
And I'm K-Wall, and this is Across Boundary Christmas.
Today, we're going to be covering our Christmas traditions that we share with our family, and we are going to give the women on this planet greatest Christmas present ever, King Sexy himself.
Is in the house.
He is in this building right now.
Amazing.
It is. You know, it took us a lot of effort to get him here today. He's a very busy man, obviously, spending a lot of time at the Palace of Love.
Yep.
But
a lot of effort and $90,000, actually.
So we will have him here today later on in this show. So
stay tuned. Oh, welcome back to Across Boundary Christmas. I'm K-Wall.
And I'm Siege.
And, you know, we're just talking about a couple of things that we like doing for Christmas time around the house. Personally, me. Christmas Eve, my family gets together, you know, relatives I haven't seen in 10 years. And other numerous people I don't even know or even in my family come knocking on my door into my house to eat my food.
I hate that.
Yes, I do too.
Every year. At least one.
Every year. And then, you know, what's more, they eat all our damn food. And they take all the presents. One year, I caught my long-lost cousin opening my gifts.
Really?
Yeah.
What was the gift?
I don't remember. I think it was a Santa hat.
Santa hat?
Yeah. Honestly.
Your parents hated you.
Yeah, they did, actually. But another thing I loved doing Christmas Eve was getting the family together and watching A Christmas Story.
Great movie.
One of the greatest Christmas movies of all time. And, you know, about a boy and his family going for Christmas. Don't you dry out. You know, classic bunny pajamas. You got it all. Anyway.
The leg lamp.
The leg lamp. Never fit the classic leg lamp. So, see, what do you do for Christmas?
You know, Christmas Eve, my family and I, we get together and we have, probably one of the most elaborate Christmas Eve dinners ever. Yes. The Outback Steakhouse. Every year.
Outback Steakhouse.
Yeah. Gotta get the Bloomin' Onion to kick things off. Gotta get a nice juicy steak in your belly before Santa comes, you know. We proceed to go home after the Outback. Yeah.
Outback Steakhouse. Okay. I'm sorry.
All right. May I continue?
Yes, I'm sorry. You can continue.
Thank you. Anyways, after the Outback, we go home to watch The Santa Claus.
Very good movie.
Great movie. Tim Allen plays a man. Scott Calvin, SC. You know?
Hey, Santa Claus.
Santa Claus. Something happens, not telling you what, because if you haven't seen it, you're missing out on life itself. So,
okay, anyways.
On to Christmas Day.
On to Christmas Day.
So,
Christmas Day.
The way it used to work for me was I could not get out of bed until 5:30 in the morning. I could open my stocking before my parents woke up, and I could wake them at 6.
Okay.
So,
okay. See,
at that point, we would commence Christmas, everybody one present at a time. That way, you know, we all got to see. And afterwards, it was play day for a couple hours with all our new, our cute boys.
Yeah, you know, Christmas for me, we'd wake up, and you know, we'd have a monstrosity of a breakfast. Usually, I was up at like 4 o'clock running around the house, banging on doors, windows. Anything to get everybody up. Yeah. You know, once everybody was seated around the family Christmas tree, kind of like the Griswolds, Christmas Vacation, it'd be a present fest.
Present fest?
Yes, there was no waiting in line. There was no none of this crazy voodoo Christmas bullshit.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that what you call my tradition?
No. Sorry. I overstepped my bounds.
You are destroying every vision of my Christmas right
now. I'm very sorry. You know, maybe next year I will, that's how
you
do that.
You should. It's beautiful. It's glorious. Anyways, after we open presents, family comes over.
Oh, God.
Dear Jesus.
Mary and Joseph.
Let me tell you something. If you ever want to see chaos, come to the Siege family reunion.
That'd be kind of scary. Are you guys all ready?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so we have a nice dinner, and then we send everybody on their way. Then the family goes to the Christmas service at our local church.
Okay.
For our Lord and Savior.
And, you know, basically after we open presents, we all kind of spread to the four winds of the house until family comes over. And, like, you know, like Christmas Eve, we see people that we haven't seen in years and people we didn't know existed. Like my Aunt Margaret. I didn't know she was alive still.
Really?
Yeah, and then she just showed up. I thought, you know, it was freaking Return of the Dead.
I have a cousin of a cousin of a cousin like that.
Oh, really?
Don't even know the guy.
Yeah.
He shows up asking for some wine.
Yeah.
Damn drunk. So,
after the break,
we got a guest.
We have a guest. King Sexy in the house, ladies.
So, cuddle up with your loved ones, sit by the fireplace, and you hang tight.
Oh, come in. King Sexy, welcome to the show. Come on, take a seat. Ladies and gentlemen, King Sexy himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, hey, what's going on? I'm the big man, myth. Damn, King Sexy, man. What's going on? What's going on, K? Well, how you doing?
I'm not doing too bad, dude. Not doing too bad. First time on the show. Gonna be, interviewing you today. Alright, King Sexy. In the house. So I'm gonna ask what probably is on every lady's mind right now. Are you single?
Are you serious? Damn right I am. Can't no bitch hold me down, man. Oh, why is this fire so hot? Come on.
Sorry,
why is this fire so hot?
I'll turn it down a little bit. I'm sorry about that. I know you.
It's right. Forgive me.
So,
first time on the show, you don't know. You don't know what I like? That's all right. Keep going.
I know in the palace it must be kind of drafty. But anyways, what have you been up to lately? I haven't seen you for a while. Last time I heard you were in Peru, like, doing some Macarena dancing down there.
What's that supposed to mean? Peru?
Yeah.
Macarena dance?
Yeah. I'm just saying. And I was getting reports from Siege that you're traveling to Europe. Checking out the problems.
All right. Yes. Traveling. I have been doing a lot of traveling.
Really?
Yes. Yes, I have. You know, just going from here.
Anyways, King Six, you know, I've been having some problems. I need your advice. I heard from multiple sources that you can help with all relationship advice.
That is the bad.
Well, I guess it's not really. It's not really my problem. It's more a friend of a friend of a friend. Should you treat me nice? So, he has this woman.
Merry Christmas, baby. You should did
like
treat me nice.
What should he do?
What's this kid?
Give me a diamond ring for Christmas. Now I'm living
Chris?
In paradise.
Check it, Chris. Yo, peep this, man. You gotta fuck that bitch.
Fine. And okay, that's that's all the time we have today, folks. King Sexy in the house with me. Merry Christmas.
Ooh,
have a good night.
I'm feeling mighty fine. I got good music in my stereo.
King Sexy, what are you doing?
Oh, shit, my bad, man. Darn. Every time.
Every time.